guys, a very good morning. This is RJ Aditya.
And this is RJ Aryan.
Welcome to Radio Bud.
The day today is very pleasant and we will be having lots of fun.
No wasting any of the time, let's get started.
Okay, first things first. We'll be taking a short interview of a great personality.
Here we have Likanshi representing all the great, but brilliant, hardworking and sincere students of class 9, APL. Likanshi, hope you're able to hear me. Sorry, and you can go for the first question.
Okay, so Likanshi, my first question is, why are you here representing all the students? I mean, why do you want to speak for them?
I feel like the students have a lot to say and express, but the thing is they don't know exactly how or where to. So here I am representing all my fellow friends and mates with an aim to let the society know about the
truth. Okay, so my second question to you is, what is students' opinion about the study pattern and extracurricular activities?
Usually, people see these extracurricular activities as a boon to enhance the students' performance, but what I concluded from my research doesn't really seem to match this opinion. Well, according to me, these extracurricular activities could sometimes be really annoying by being so time-consuming, and it can even affect our grades. Like, not everyone is a pro in time management, right? We are all just middle school teenagers who are just...
This means that you're against the school education pattern?
Not really, but nothing is flawless, right?
What is your opinion about the teachers? How are their teaching skills?
The teachers are the best and I bet they're watching it live right now, so I'm no comments. I don't want to repeat anything again, so yeah.
So, according to you as a final conclusion, what all things need to be changed?
Well, there are a lot of changes that can be made. One of them could be changing the evaluation system, which is now only based upon a 3-hour exam, and it can be changed into focusing more on the classroom participation of the students. So like in this way they can give their best, and there are a lot of ways for improving the education system, and it only matters when they are actually implemented. So the schools and the government should try doing this.
Thank you for giving us your time, Meghanshi, and hope your demands will meet the principal ma'am.
Okay, I think Aryan is looking little tired, so we will meet you after a cup of coffee. Till then, don't go anywhere, stay on Radio Buzz, sponsored by water bottles and powered by Flexi.
Are you looking for a durable bottle? If yes, your hunt is over, because here we present water bottles.
So my second question to you both is, how do you pronounce Y-E-L?
Obviously, yes. Yes.
Okay. So how will you pronounce E-Y-E-S?
It's a piece of a cake. We will pronounce it as E-Yes.
Are you sure, gentlemen?
100% sure.
100% sure.
And what if I say this is wrong?
Are you kidding or what?
So you only tell how will we pronounce it?
It was simple.
Oh, yes.
Oh no.
Okay, now the third question. Which is the most coolest channel and will be qualified to the finale?
Of course, Radio Buzz.
No doubt in it, it's Radio Buzz.
No doubt in this too that you both have got this point.
Surprisingly, we don't only have one winner, but we have two winners. That's great.
Yo, and the surprise gift you are getting is people should be from the class, so you can ask them for that. Or you can answer the English teacher, not us.
What is it?
You wasted a lot of time, gentlemen.
Guys, thank you for being with us. We'll come tomorrow again. Till then, goodbye, take care, wash your hands again and again, and don't forget to wear your mask even if you're going to nearby leave.
Follow us on Twitter at radio_buzz_01 and on Instagram at radiobuzz.02 and on Facebook at hello_radio.
Hello everyone. So my next role play is Radha from the lesson Who I Am. So let's start. Hello everyone. My name is Radha. I am 12 years old. My favorite activity is to climb the trees. Just outside of our house, there is a mango tree, which I love to go up. Its branches spread out, so it's simple to climb up the tree, and I can sit comfortably in the fork of two branches. My mother tells me it is not sensible for girls to climb trees. But one afternoon, she climbed up too. And both of us sat there talking and eating raw mangoes. When I am high up in the tree, I feel like I can rule the whole world. Thank you, Mom. Have a nice day. Hello, everyone. My name is Rishmita. I am from class 6A. Today, I am going to play a role of Tolma from the lesson Who I Am. So, let's start. Hello, my name is Tolma. I am 12 years old. My dream is when I will grow up, I am going to be the Prime Minister of India. Everyone laughs when I say that, but I am sure that one day I will do it. Everyone in my class asks me what to do when they have some problem. And my teacher always trusts me for everything something needs to be done in school. I want to make things better for everyone. I want us to have good hospitals, schools and roads. I want to make sure that there are many good scientists in India who will invent cures for diseases and send a spaceship to Mars. Thank you, Mom. Have a nice day.
My name is Ara Mittal from class 7th. Role-playing activity. The chapter The Invention of Vita Wong is taken from the book Honeycomb. This is about the invention of a potion which makes people old. There are two characters in the story, Charlie and the narrator, which is Mr. Wonka. Mr. Willy Wonka begins by inventing Wonka White, which makes people younger. But Wonka White is too strong. Some people disappear because their age becomes minus. So Mr. Wonka must invent a new thing to reverse the effect. The role of Mr. Wonka will be played by Aramithi. So once again, I roll my sleeves and set to work. Once again, I squeeze my brain searching for the new recipe. I had to create age to make people oldest. Haha, I cried, for the ideas were beginning to come. What is the oldest living thing in the world? What lives longer than anything else? A tree, Charlie said. Right you are, Charlie. But what kind of tree? Not the Douglas fir, not the oak, not the cedar. No, my boy. It is a tree called the bristlecone pine that grows up on the slopes of Wheeler Peak in Nevada, USA. You can find bristlecone pines on Wheeler Peak today that are over 4,000 years old. This is fact, Charlie. Ask any dendrochronologist you like. So that started me off. I jumped into the great glass elevator and rushed all over the world collecting special items from the oldest living things. A pint of sap from a 4,000-year-old bristlecone pine. The toenail clippings from a 168-year-old Russian farmer called Petrovich Grigorovich. An egg laid by a 200-year-old tortoise belonging to the King of Toga. The tail of a 51-year-old horse in Arabia. The whiskers of a 36-year-old cat called Crumpets. An old flea which had lived on crumpets for 36 years. The tail of a 207-year-old giant frog from Tibet. The black teeth of a 97-year-old grimalkin living in a cave on Mount Popocatépetl. The knuckle bones of a 700-year-old cattle from Peru. Thank you.
Good morning, Mom, and all my dear friends. Today, I, Aradhana Kumari from class 60, is going to play the role of Dolama from chapter number 6. So let's start. Hello, I am Dolama of 11 years. This is my thought is that when I grow up, I am going to be the Prime Minister of India. People always laugh when I say that, but I am sure that I will do it. Everyone in my class asks me that what to do when they have a problem, and my teacher always trusts me when something needs to be done in school. I want to make things better for everyone. I want us to have good hospitals and roads and schools. I want to make sure that there are many good scientists in India who will invent cures for diseases and send spaceship to Mars. Thank you.
Morning, Allahabad. Today we have a very special guest in our show, Mr. Shubham Srivastava, the writer of this book, Perception. You are listening to Lesson 2, Big FM, with RJ Harsh and RJ Diksha. Keep going.
Struggle you are in today is developing the strength you need for tomorrow. With this beautiful quote, welcome guys. My name is Harsh Shukla and I'm from 97.2 Red FM and I'm your host and RJ, and we are having a guest who don't need any type of introduction, as he's Shubham Shivastav, who is known for his book Perception.
Hello everyone, it's RJ Diksha on 97.2 Red FM.
Okay sir, so please tell us something about yourself, as what do you do?
Hello, my name is Shubham Shivastav and I'm from Prayagraj. After completing my education, I started my career as an educator, and I'm currently working as TGP Physics at Army Public School, New Kent, Allahabad.
So sir, our public wants to know that when did you started writing books?
As far as I remember, I started writing since my high school days. Adolescence is the age of stress and strain, and I soon realized that writing gives me pleasure. And that's how I started writing.
So guys, I know that you would be quite excited to know more about Shubham Shivastav. So let's come back after a short break.
Let's listen to a very amazing joke between a man and a relative. A relative said, "Son, what's your age?" The guy replied, "It's 25, uncle." The relative said, "When will you marry, son?" "It's the time to marry." The guy replied, "Soon, uncle." "What's your age, uncle?" The relative said, "It's 70, son." The guy replied, "It's the time to death. When will you die, uncle?" What the savage reply by the guy to the man. It's a tit for tat.
So, welcome back guys. As you know that we are having a series of questions with Shubham Shivastav, who is known for his book Perception. So, sir, our public wants to know that when was your first book published?
I was in third year of my graduation when my first book was published. So before becoming anything, even before completing my education, I became an author. It was a collection of poems and its name was Starring You and Me.
Wow, exciting sir. We really wants to know that when and how did the idea come of writing your latest book, that is Perception?
The idea of Perception came when I started writing about reality. I started writing whatever I feel I see in reality, and that's how the idea about Perception.
So guys, we will continue our communication with Shubham Shivastav after a short break. Thank you.
Audible. Listen to your favorite audiobooks, podcasts, stories and more whenever you like, and experience performances that bring stories to life with Audible.
So welcome back guys, as you know that we are having a series of questions with Shubham Shivastav, who is known for his book Perception.
What was your main intention in writing the book Perception?
The main intention of writing Perception is to make people understand about individual differences. I realized that there's a lot of chaos regarding different point of view of different people. That's when I realized that I should write something based on people's different point of view. Perception describes different topics of the world in my own point of view, and I try to describe things differently.
Are there any future plans for writing the other books?
Since I'm into education sector, I've realized that this generation wants something out of the box. And I'm now planning to write books for students, and I would love to start with my favorite subject, that is physics. Thank you.
Let's take a break and listen to a wonderful joke.
To a very amazing joke between a man and a god. Once a man said to God, "How many million years is for you?" The god said, "It's just a minute for me." Then the man said, "How many dollars is for you?" Then the god said gently, "It's a penny for me." Then the man said, "God, please you give me a penny." Then the god said, "Just wait a minute." What a savage reply by God to man. This is an irony to tit for tat.
Oh, Good evening, ma'am. Today, we students of class 8D are playing a role play in front of you. The title of our role play is Having a Best Friend. The cast of our role play is the narrator is played by Sachin Tiwari, and the first friend role, which is Sam, is being played by Arpan Kumar Mishra, and the second friend, which is Jack, it is played by Sajal, and the editor of our video is Harshit. This story tells about that there were two friends, Jack and Sam, who were walking through the desert. During some point of the journey, they had an argument and Jack slapped Sam on his face.
What do you say?
Take this.
Today, my best friend slapped me on the face.
They kept on walking until they found an oasis where they decided to take a bath.
Jack, please save me.
Don't panic, my friend. I will save you.
Today, my best friend saved my life.
After I heard you wrote in the sand. Now, I have saved your life. Why you wrote in the stone that I have saved your life?
When someone hurts us, we should write it down in sand, where winds of forgiveness can erase it away. But when someone does good for us, we must engrave it in stone, where no winds can erase it away.
The moral of our story is that don't value what you have in your life, but value who you have in your life. Thank you.
So we will meet you after a cup of coffee. Till then, don't go anywhere. Stay on Radio Buzz, sponsored by water bottles and powered by
Lucky. Are you looking for a durable bottle? If yes, your hunt is over, because we have represent water bottles. Bottle, durable than any other bottle. Do you want a cheaper one? Bottle, cheaper than any other bottle. Do you want a fancy one? Bottle, fancy than any other bottle. Shop today only.
Flex issue, the best of the best and more flexible than the rest. People wear shoes to act cool, but flex issues do make everyone cool. It's just for the best of the best, because it was made by hard work from the West. Why don't you buy the flexi shoe? After all, it is meant for you. Buy the flexible flexi shoe, which is waiting for you. Buy it just for $4,992. Flexi shoe, since 1992.
The most liked show, Radio Buzz, sponsored by water bottles and powered by flexi shoe. Okay, so I'm thinking of having a little fun. And you know what I'm going to do. Let's go for a prank call.
Hi, am I speaking with Anjali?
Yes, it's me, Anjali here.
Hey Anjali, Aryan this side. I'm speaking from IELTS. You applied for Canada's visa through IELTS, am I correct?
Yes.
Your exam is scheduled for 4th February. It will be a reading, listening and writing test. However, we will reschedule your listening test, which is going to start in 20 seconds.
It what? Is the test going to be taken right now?
Oh yes, it is going to be starting in 15 to 20 seconds from now. Please get ready with your pen and paper, and after 20 seconds, I'll be transferring your call to the IVRS.
But sir, I'm not prepared for the test yet. I did not get any information about the test being rescheduled.
I'm sorry ma'am, but this is not negotiable. Please get ready with a pen and paper. Your exam is going to start shortly.
Wait sir, I need some time. I'm going to get my pen and paper.
Anjali, listen to this conversation very quickly and carefully, and good luck with the exam.
Test is about to start. You will be listening to a conversation between two people. Meanwhile, some questions will be asked to you. Here we go. Hello.
Hi, this is Aryan. I wanted to inquire.
A very good morning to all of you. Today, I, Jagriti Singh from class 8B, is going to play
a fable in front of you all, in which I have played the role of narrator. The role of rabbit and lion is played by Deep Lakshmi. Sanya has played the role of elephant, and the role of monkey is played by Rashi. The title of our story is The Great Elephant. One day, an elephant wandered into a jungle in search of friends. He saw a monkey jumping on the trees and taught him to make friends.
Will you be my friend? Please, I don't have any friends.
You are too big, and even you can't swing on trees like me. So I think why I should make you friend.
The next day, elephant saw a rabbit playing in his burrow.
Will you like to be my friend?
Very large, you can't play with me in my burrow. I need friends who can play with me in my burrow.
The elephant was so disappointed that no one is making him friend. The next day, he saw all the animals running here and there in the jungle. Elephant asked the monkey,
what is the matter? Why you all are in hurry?
There is a lion, he tried to kill all of us.
The elephant went to the lion and said,
please, Mr. Lion, don't eat up all these poor animals.
Mind your own business.
The elephant has now no choice but to teach a lesson to the lion. He fought with the lion and won. He came back to the jungle, and all the animals of the jungle thanked him by saying,
you are just a right size to be our friend.
So, the moral of our story is, the friend is deep, is the friend indeed. Thank you.
What?
Hi, Aryan. Yes, sure, why not?
I live around the Tanker Road, and there are some issues I'm facing regarding the school admissions.
Would be the happiest to help you, Aryan.
Thank you so much. I wanted to inquire how many schools exactly would be around my locality, that is, the Tanker Road.
I think Tanker Road has exactly 5 schools, Aryan.
Wow, that's great. I hope there are some top-tier schools there as well. Your first question is, how many burgers did Aditya eat for lunch?
Burger is not mentioned in the conversation.
That reminds me, Aditya, how do I commute from home to work daily?
You can call a taxi or travel by local trains to the work. If your workplace is nearby, you can even wait for a bus. It's on you.
Wow, that makes my commute easy and doesn't cost much too.
Next question is, what is the color of Aryan's shirt?
Ridiculous. The color of Aryan's shirt was not mentioned in the conversation.
Aditya, please show me your hand.
Okay, here it is.
And here is a gift.
Wow, that's great, Aryan. Thank you very much.
Your next question is, what did Aryan give to Aditya?
I want my money back. I want a refund. Give me my money back. Hello? Hello? Just give me my money back.
You want your fees back?
Yes, I want my fees back.
Then you need to answer one final question. Who is making a fool out of you?
What?
Aryan, who else could be other than the RGs of Radio Buzz? Okay, Anjali, this was the RGs of Radio Buzz. Thank you for giving your time. Thank you. Okay guys, let's have some more fun by playing a simple game. The game is that we would be calling any two of the players from the audience and would be asking some questions. The one who will answer it correctly and quickly will be the winner.
Okay, here we have Saurabh and Athar for the game. And we have a surprise gift for the winner too. So, the first question to the both of you is, who are the most coolest and entertaining RJs for you guys?
The most I like are the RJ Rahul and RJ Navin from Radio Mirchi, because they have a good sense of humor and good interacting skills.
Okay, Saurabh, thank you for that, and this point is yours. No doubt in this. So my second question to you both is, how do you pronounce Y-E-S?
Obviously, yes.
Yes.
Okay. So how will you pronounce?
Give me love. You are my love. If you only love to hate me.
Good. The song was pretty awesome. Okay, I think we got our first follow today.
Let's pick it up. Hello. Hi.
Hi. I'm Nidhi Myra, teacher teaching in Army Public School, New Kent, Prayagraj.
Well, ma'am, that's great. Do you share experience in our online studies?
Yeah, about the experience, I would say, even
for that. And let's take a little break. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. You're listening to your today's RJ Krishi Kumari. So here, let's have a story presented by Isha Thakur.
Great one. Written and a great one indeed. Empress all time. Ruled from Maurya in the 4th century. Of his village name, father was Chandragupta Maurya, the founder of Maurya dynasty. And his father name was Bindusara. Ashoka was so mighty that his empire included almost the entire Indian subcontinent except today's Tamil Nadu and Kerala. His capital was Patliputra, which is the present-day Patna. The Indian state Bihar was such an incredible ruler that the day we know about Ashoka from scriptures such as Ashoka Vanda, Mahavatma, and his own sacred inscriptions in Kulur Sangha.
Okay, we have the caller to answer the question which I have asked before the break. Let's listen her answer.
Hello, I'm Disha. So, as your question is, what would I ask for if God would grant me a wish? So, basically, I'm a food lover, like every time crazy for food. I could die for eating tasty pav bhaji, chole bhature, pani puri and momos, as they are my favorite of all time. So, from God, I would ask for a kind of power to have tasty and delicious food within a second, wherever or whenever I want. Like whenever I'm hungry or whenever I want to get out of my boredom. And the reason behind asking for such kind of wish is like food is my first love. That's all. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Disha, for joining us.
So lastly, let's have a song presented by Akash.
Na na na, avdi ma, na na na, let me love. Let me love you. Dajki na 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 na. Aungi na 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 na.
Thank you all of you for joining us today. Signing off, RJ Krishi Kumari.
Oh, good morning to the teachers and all my dear friends. Today, I, Asha Rajput of Class 8C, is going to play the role of Niece Vera from the story The Open Window. So let's start. Hello everyone, I'm Vera and I'm 16 years old. I am the niece of my aunt Mrs. Sappleton, and today I am going to tell you something about me. Listen, I am a very good storyteller. I can make any story anytime and told it like that it has happened in the real life. I have done this with a person named Frampton Noodle. I don't know who is that person. He is a stranger for me. Then, after telling his name, he started telling his problem, that he has some bad nerves and so on. Then I make a plan and said that my uncle Mr. Sappleton and my aunt's two brothers were gone on hunting 3 years ago from the open window and they never came back. My aunt is still hoping that they will come back from the open window one day. After listening this, the Frampton was totally frightened. After some time, he saw three figures coming from the open window. After seeing that, he rushed in a hurry without saying anything. Then my uncle Mr. Sappleton said that who was that person? I again told a fool a fake story that he was Frampton Noodle and he has fears of dogs. That's why he ran in a hurry. And you all will believe that everyone say, okay, we believe you. So, you will also believe me that it is true. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.
Hey, hello everyone. Good morning. This is Monday morning and you're listening to your favorite show, Breaky Morning with RJ Krishi Kumari. You are tuned to the frequency 107.2 wave FM, the FM you love. So the time is 9:31 AM and the weather is pretty cool, I think so. So let's start a beautiful morning with a beautiful song presented by Disha Pandey.
Love, 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 love. How you love to hate me. Gonna send a tear like that. Feeling a finger when you are like that. Driving for a going for a swish dash. Swish, dash, swish, dash. Stressing over nothing but the real time. While you're getting young, you're a kid back. Only thing I think about is faces. Rest, rest. Negative days, negative nights. Baby, you're wasting all your time. I can't relate, I can't believe. No more drama in my life.
wake up? Yeah, makeup, maybe. Managing, I've been good lately. Growing up, working, busy. You were my love, if you only love to hate me. Love, 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 love. How you love to hate me. Love. You were my love, if you only love to hate me. I'ma let you fade into the background. Baby, all my shows are getting too loud. Keep on turning it up when you want me down. Down. Negative days, negative nights. Baby, you're wasting all your time. I can't relate, I keep it light. No drama in my life. Wake up, yeah. Make up, maybe. Need you now. Fingers lazy, blowing up, working busy. You are my love, if you only love to hate me. Love. I will love to hate me. Love. You are my love, if you only love to hate me. Love, you hate me, you hate to love me. I'm taken back, but just taken from me. Taken, honey, there's something that remind me that I'd be alone on my own. If I needed you, I had it that I know. Hold up, I could do it by myself. Don't need help, one of a kind of hand that I was dealt. Like a well said, Cupid was stupid. I shouldn't know it, cause I've been through it. You wouldn't do it if it ain't foolish. Stupid. You and for my love, if you only.
Good afternoon, fam. I am Ayushi of class 8C and my role number is 12. Today I am doing a role play of a poet. The name of the poem is The Schoolboy. The poem is all about a schoolboy who is unhappy. He says that his childhood is crumbled for the sake of learning and teaching. The boy likes morning, trees and birds. He loves being in nature, but however, due to his schools, his mornings are unpleasant and unhappy. He does not like going to school and also is not interested in studies and book. He spends his day in sadness and dismay. He sits for hours in school in anxiousness and dropping. He does not like going to school. In school, he feels like a small girl who is in a cage who wants to sing but can't. He asks his parent that he is like a small girl who is destroyed at an early stage and whose happiness is driven away. In this case, the summer morning is not at all joyful. At last, the poet further advises the parents and not deprive the child joy and happiness that they deserve. In case we have unhappy children, the life will be full of sorrow and unhappy. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Ruskin Bond. Wanted to tell you all about my short monsoon diary. Once I went to Mussoorie, Uttarakhand, June 24th. My first day. It is the time when monsoon begins. The mist silences the bird song and conceals the hill, making everything invisible. By June 25, humidity emerges as they begin receiving some early monsoon rain. The first cobra lily wears its head from the ferns, describing the hill station and valley in one sentence, a paradise that might have seen. The rain also heralds the arrival of a few seasonal visitors like the leopard, leeches, scarlet minivets and drongos. Because of the downpour, there is no dearth of food for the insect-eating birds. On August 2, the springing leaks from the tin roof made me feel touched by the rain while actually remaining untouched. By the 12th day of August, Mussoorie had been receiving showers for a stretch of 8 to 9 days straight. They had nowhere to go. One could only pace in the room or look out of the window. The last day of August marked the peak of the lush monsoon growth. The red denim of the seeds of the lily cobra signified that the rains are about to come to an end and the ferns will now start turning yellow. With October comes the winter rain bringing snow on the higher altitude. The late March marked the end of the winter season when the hill station experiences the darkest clouds that make way for a rainbow to form after it has hailed, thus leaving the sky clear. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Soumya Pandey from class 9th H and today I am going to do the role play of Maria Sharapova from Reach for the Top. Hey everybody, I am Maria Sharapova. and I won the women's singles at Wimbledon in 2004. And today I am here to share my journey, life journey with you all. So, first of all, I made lots of sacrifices in my life. Starting from the age of 9 years, when most of the children start to think that what they have to do and what they have to do in future. I was packed off in the train to US, leaving my mom behind in Norway. You know, it was not a good time for me. I used to feel so lonely. And my dad worked so hard to keep my training practice going, so he was also not able to see me either. And because I was so young, I used to go to bed early, like around 8 p.m. And the other girls would come in at 11 p.m. and they would ask me to tidy up the room. And instead of all those things, and instead of letting all those things depress me, I became quietly determined and more mentally tough. You know, I never thought of quitting because I know what I wanted. Remember, when you come from nothing and you have nothing, you become more hungry and determined. And that toughness ran through my body every day. And when I look back at those times, I think that was only the key that led me win the Wimbledon. Now, keeping all those sacrifices aside, let me tell you about my hobbies. I love singing, dancing, and fashion very much. In eating, I love pancakes with chocolate spread with fizzy orange juice. Yum! They're so tasty. So, that's all. At last, I just want to tell you my 3 mantras of success. First of all, you should have the unwavering desire to succeed. Because if you don't have the dream and that desire that yes, I want that thing, then you cannot succeed. Second, the readiness to sacrifice. Never be back from sacrificing anything, because you never know that what sacrifice of yours can lead you to achieving your dream.
Good morning everyone, this is Ayush Kumar of class 8C, and today I will be in the role of Ranji, a character in a book's chapter, The Fight. Hello everyone, this is Ranji and I live in a thirsty town which is middle of the Rajputna desert, and today I am going to tell a story about my visit to Rajpur village where I discovered something very different. So let's get started. I was in my village for almost less than a month and I was walking in the forest with vests and shorts. But seriously, I'm telling you that day was the most hottest day of that year. After some time, I found one pool that was very transparent to see the pebbles under the water very easily. It was very cool water, so that I went into the pool for fun. But this was my first time in such a cool pool, because our town pools were only used for washing clothes and washing of animals. And next day I came again. And then after rest on the rock. After some time, a boy came up and tell me go away from them. I was trying to be friendly with him, but he called me for a fight, as I thought to be a fighter and not frightened and fight with him. After that, he were fighting for a long time, and when we got tired, we got a homes back, and we decided to fight tomorrow. And I said, okay, I will. My mother scolded me for the bruises and cuts on my knees and all over my body. And then in the evening, I went to the bazaar for refreshments and I ate jalebis and drank lemonade from the bottle. After I saw my opponent in the bazaar, I don't see at him, and second, to throw the empty lemonade bottle to him. But I didn't do neither of it. I was just grilled out. After came the next day for the fight, but I didn't want to go because I was tired. But I still go for the fight because I don't want to lose. After that, when I go to the river, I surprise him with my swimming skills, and also I was impressed by his wrestling skills. He said that his name is Suraj and he went to learn swimming skills from me, and also I said I to learn the swimming wrestling skills from him, and then we became friends. Thank you.